Today, we'll take a look at the FCPX Transitions Mega Pack from the sponsor of this video, Pixel Film Studios. With this bundle, you get 8 complete plugins at $240 value for only $69.95. And as icing on the cake, I have an additional discount on this pack for my viewers, details at the end of this video. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. When you purchase the FCPX Transitions Mega Pack, you get 8, you heard me right, 8 complete plugins. Most of these plugins come with hundreds of unique animations, all fully customizable. When installing these plugins, especially if you're in Catalina, you might run into a permissions issue getting this message. All you have to do here is click OK, go to your settings, and in the Security and Privacy section, select the General tab. Click the lock icon at the bottom and click Open Anyways. Click Open in the next pop-up window and the installer will do the rest. You should only have to do this once. So with the plugins installed, let's jump into Final Cut Pro and take a look at a few of my favorites included. First, let's take a look at my favorite transition pack included in this bundle, the TransZoom Mask. This pack allows you to quickly and easily create mask zoom transitions like this one without having to keyframe anything. Let's take a look at how I made the transition you just seen. Down in my timeline, I have my two clips I want to transition between. I've trimmed my first clip to end where the eye is fully open. I'll open the transitions browser and select the Pixel Film Studios TransZoom Mask category. For my example, I'll select a zoom in transition and drag and drop it between my clips. I'll move my playhead to where the pupil is nice and big, and with the transition clip selected, in the viewer, draw a mask around the pupil. If you're masking a round object like me, you can curve the lines between your control points. After adding the control point, hold down the Shift key and click on the control point. You'll get two white handles extending from the control point. Adjust these handles to curve the connecting line. I'll click on my first control point to close my mask. This is what we have so far. Looks good, but we can make it look even better. I'll move my playhead to where I can see both clips, make sure the transition clip is selected, and head up to the inspector window. There's a bunch of adjustable parameters here you can play with to make this transition nice and smooth. In the mask controls, I'll drop the fade in speed all the way down, bring up the softness slider to around 30, and set the softness radius to around 3. I'll add a bit of blur, bring up a flash slider to about there. Let's see what this looks like. Another plugin included in this bundle I find myself using all the time is the TransPan 1.1 pack. It includes a bunch of transition presets, and these are so simple to use. You just select one of the presets you want to use, drag and drop it between your clips, and if you want to, adjust a few settings in the inspector. Let the clip render out and you're done. It's that simple. Now, with this bundle, you get a lot, and I mean a lot of transition presets. If I went through every one of them, we'd be here all day. So what I've done is just pick a few of my favorites just so you can get an idea of what to expect and put together a short demo sequence. And before I go, if this bundle is something you're interested in, when checking out, use the coupon code SurgePixel for an additional 30% off this bundle, limited to the first 500 downloads. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week. We'll be right back.
Small is the number of 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 small is